Welcome to the Patient Educators Update, where we focus on patient educators and patient education topics in a clinical environment. My name is Chuck Jones, and our guest today is Fran London. Fran is the health education specialist for Phoenix Children's Hospital in Phoenix, Arizona. She has published dozens of articles and two books on patient education, including No Time to Teach, The Essence of Patient and Family Education for Healthcare Providers, which has been awarded the 2010 Book of the Year by the American Journal of Nursing. Hi, Fran. Welcome.
Thank you, Chuck. Hi.
How's everything going?
Great.
Super. Well, our topic today is going to be teaching with tools. And by tools, I'm talking about things like booklets or handouts or maybe, and you could probably elaborate on the types of things that are available. So the first question is, why should a nurse educator use tools? What's the benefit?
Well, there are two big reasons. One is the more parts of the brain you engage in the teaching process, the more senses you involve, the more connections you make, and the better people are going to remember and understand stuff.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
So pictures, words, conversation, they all add to the message.
That makes sense. I know, you know, I'm a visual learner, so I'm better if you can show me. My brain is so ADD now, if you tell me something, I forget it in 20 seconds, and that's just, the older I get, the worse it is.
And another advantage of handouts is that they can take them home and refer to them later.
Okay, sure. That makes
sense.
So if
they forget.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes total sense. And I guess that nowadays, we didn't talk about this prior to starting the show, but the internet could be a tool for something like this. So almost giving them something they can take with them can supplement the internet or be a little bit better because they have something they're taking with them. They can even talk about it in the car on the way home.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, let me ask you a question about assessment, which is one of your big points about education. Is there a way to determine during assessment whether or not a patient is a good candidate for teaching with tools or maybe how to approach them with pamphlets and things of that nature?
Well, you don't want to use written materials for someone who can't read. Pictures might be good, but words would just alienate them.
Gotcha.
So it's important to ask them something like, the last time you wanted to learn something, how did you go about it?
Well, that's a good question.
An answer, yeah, that doesn't involve words at all. You might want to explore that a little bit more.
Yeah, that makes total sense because I was going to ask you, how do you ask somebody if they can read without embarrassing them? And that the way you phrased that question is just dead on. And you said the last time you tried to learn something, what did you say? How did you do it? Or
the last time you wanted to learn something, how did you go about it?
Okay.
Because that way they could think about, you know, whether they wanted to learn how to paint a chair or hang a picture or whatever it is, how did they learn?
Okay, that makes sense. I know when things break around the house, I go to YouTube, and there's always somebody on YouTube who's fixed a washer, fixed a dryer, or done something like that. It's just incredible how much stuff is there.
So you're visual.
Yes, I am. Absolutely. Well, now, let's talk about the nurse educator right now. Is there a special process or a special way that a nurse should use a booklet or a pamphlet or a tool to teach with? Is there one right way?
Again, it depends on the situation and the people involved and the relationship. The key really when you're using paper is don't assume the paper can do the teaching for you. That so much is the conversation around what's in the paper.
Well, now, wait a minute now. You're telling me that when last time my wife was in the hospital and the day we discharged, the nurse came in and she gave us something that looked like it had been copied about 1,000 times. And she said, read this when you get home and it'll help answer any questions. You're saying we shouldn't do that?
I'm saying you shouldn't do that.
Well, I think that may be the norm where in the hospitals we've been to.
Well, we're trying to change behaviors now.
Okay. Well, I'm all in for that. That's why we're talking. Okay. Now, is there a best way that the nurse should interact with the patient or the family member? Have you found one way that works?
I like giving it to read to the patient, the learner, whoever it is, and then reviewing it with them, asking them the key points to repeat back, to do the teach back on. If there's something very important you want them to know, use a highlighter and highlight that. That individualizes the booklet or the handout for that patient, and it indicates to them this is very important information.
Okay, now that makes sense, but to me, do you do that in one visit, or do you drop it off, have them read it, tell them you're going to come back and talk about it a second time, like an hour later, or is that the way you do that?
Yeah, I think, again, if you use teaching throughout a hospitalization, you need to start from the beginning and then refer back to whatever it is throughout with each visit.
Okay, that makes total sense. Is there anything or any tips that you have that patient educators should avoid, things not to do with tools?
The most important thing not to do with tools or in other circumstances is to say, "Did you understand that?"
Okay. Because the answer you're going to get is yes.
Sure. And yeah, it's not effective. It's a waste of time.
Yeah, but it's the most common question.
Yeah.
Did you understand? Well, sure. Because that means you'll leave and you won't ask me any other questions, right?
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Which is not really what we want people to do. Well, that makes a whole lot of sense. Okay, well, this has been pretty helpful. Now, in your book, you do some, you have some very specific chapters about how to use different types of tools. And in some future shows, we're going to talk very specifically about each tool. Everything from posters to flip cards. We'll talk about video. We'll talk about the internet. We'll even talk about using interpreters, because in today's environment, that's really important. And so we'll dig into this in much more detail in some future episodes. So thanks very much for your time today. I found it very beneficial.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, thanks to our guest, Fran London. She's the author of No Time to Teach. Her book is available wherever books are sold in both paper and ebook form, so you can check out Amazon or your favorite book supplier. And for hospitals, you can get quantity purchases of her book and save up to 40% by contacting her publisher, Pritchard & Hull, at p-h.com. And we'll have links to these in the show notes. You can also keep up with Fran in two places. She's very active on her blog, which is notimetoteach.com. And she's also active on Twitter, and her Twitter handle is at No Time to Teach. The Patient Educators Update is brought to you by Synergy Broadcast Systems and our Education on Demand system, MMDS, that provides video-based patient education to help patients and their families prepare for a successful discharge and home health care after leaving the hospital. You can find out more about MMDS and Video on Demand on our website at synergybroadcast.com. Thanks for watching. Fran, I'll see you next time.
Okay, bye.